Hello and welcome back to my addition to the Games Plus James tutorials. This is episode 2 for me, but 42 in the Games Plus James series. Last time we built the inventory system so you could pick things up and it would record it for you. This time we're going to add some visuals to that because you need to be able to see what's in your inventory. So that's the plan. Let's get started. So the first thing we need to do is add the view of the inventory. So that's going to be in our canvas. So if we go to the canvas, create a new child object for the inventory. So a new empty, call that inventory. And then in the inventory, we need to add, let's just resize this first so it looks fairly central on the screen. Something like that. And then let's add an image to that. So add, where is it? 2D object. No, UI. Image. And then resize that so it fits the canvas object. There we go. And we're going to change the color because I don't really like a plain white image. Something like that might be all right. That looks okay. And then I want another image. We'll just call that the background first so we don't get confused. Background. And then another image, UI image, put it to the top, and we'll call this the header, and then add some text so that people know what they're looking at. So text. It's just inventory. So it's not the fanciest, but it does the job. So that's the background to the inventory. We won't be able to view and then unview the inventory. When we press a button, maybe when we press I, for example. What we're going to do in the inventory, we're going to have 10 slots. So I need 10 more images. So let's create an image. UI image, we want it 100 by 100, just so it's easy to do the sums with. Put it over here. And then we need to add a background image so it looks like a slot. So I've got these two images that I'll add to our art folder. So one's a box and one's a box with a yellow color, so that we'll use that in a minute, and that'll be the image we show when we're selecting something. So first of all, get our image, pull the box into the image. There we go. I'm gonna call this inventory slot background. And I'll explain why in a moment. So now we have this. I want to make 9 more copies of it. So let's get this right. So that one's minus 277 and 36. So this needs to be minus 277. And I've got. So it exactly lines up. So I've got two inventory positions. So now I've got that one and that one. Copy them. Again, it was minus 277 and 36. So minus 2177. Again, line them up. Go, and then let's do the same thing again. So get all four of them, drag them across, is that right? Looks right to me. So, and then we need one more, so we'll get one more, not that and that. Drag it across. Need one less. So, if we look at this one, that was minus 277, so this needs to be minus 177, this needs to be minus 77, this needs to be plus 23, this needs to be plus 123, okay, 277, 177, minus 77, plus 23, 1, 2, 3. They all should be 64. So those got them to. Minus 64. Okay. So now they all line up. It was a bit of a mess on, but they all line up with each other. So just grab them and move them into the middle of this object. About there. Down a bit. So we now have 10 slots in an inventory. Now these are the background. So if there's nothing in there, this is what you want to be able to see. But we also need the exact same set on top. Now the reason for that is so that if we put what we're going to do is that we're going to change the image from a white slot with a black line around it to whatever the inventory picture is. The inventory picture needs to sit on top of something that looks exactly like that. So it'll make more sense when we get there. But just be aware that that's what's happening. So let's change. The first 10 will stay like that. The next 10 will give a name so that we know that these are the actual images that we're gonna change. So this is inventory slot one. I'll go back and change the names in a second. Inventory slot 2, inventory slot 3, 4, 5, So we've got 10 inventory slots and 10 backgrounds for the inventory slot. And that's all we're going to do to build the inventory window. So the next thing we need to do is create a script for the inventory. So we'll go to our scripts folder, create a new C# script, and we'll call this inventory imaging. Okay, so if we're doing anything with the user interface, we need to include the Unity engine.ui. Now we need to make a reference to our inventory. So public game object inventory. We need to make reference to our 10 images. So public image array. We're not going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're going to make an array so that we can then dynamically select them, which you'll see shortly. Inventory position. And a public sprite. Inventory sprite. So what we'll do is, in our inventory, we'll select an image slot, so either 1 or 2 or 3, and then put the sprite that corresponds with what's in our inventory in there. So we'd say, put a picture of a barrel in inventory position 2. See? So that's what they'll be used for. We need a public image selector. So that's the yellow box that we're going to move around, which I should have added when I was building that, but I didn't. So we'll go back in a moment and do that. And then what we're doing here is we need to track where the selector currently is. So over what position is it? So is it position 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? On the x-axis, and is it on line 1 or 2 on the y? Selector. So that's what they'll be used for. Okay, so what we're going to do then is have a way to change the image just by telling it, just by feeding it a couple of numbers. So we need a void. Void, let's call it change image. And then an integer for the new inventory position. And an integer for the sprite that we're going to use. So new inventory sprite. So what we're saying is the image object needs to be updated with the image object at the position that we're calling. So if it's 1, so it would be inventory position 1.sprite needs to change to whatever the new sprite is. So what we're going to do is have a list of various sprites that are available in the game as inventory objects, and then just give it to that. So once we save this, I'll show you how we're going to do that. So that's how we're going to change the image. It'll make more sense in a moment. We also need a way to show and not show the inventory. So we'll do this the same way as James did with his dialogue stuff. So public void for inventory. Should have done is add a public rule to say whether the inventory is active, because we need to know whether when you turn, press left or right up or down, we need to know whether that means you want the player to do that or do we want the inventory selector to do that. So we need to know if it's active. So once you press a button, for example, I, it would go show the inventory, so then I'll say the inventory is active, and then inventory dot set active true. And then we need to do the opposite for hide the inventory. Okay. Right. As I said earlier, we need another one of these. This now needs to be the selector. So it needs to be exactly the same, but with a yellow picture. So where is that art? So that this selector can move around changing the picture. Okay. Do we want to do that? Actually, no. I think a better way to do it would be to change this inventory slot picture. Yeah, I'll get rid of that. Let's forget I said that. Okay, so let's connect a script to our inventory. So what was it called? Inventory something or other. I'm going to do imaging. So inventory position, we want 10 inventory positions. 10 inventory positions. And we want 10 inventory sprites. We want it to start off inactive. And we need to get rid of that selector. We don't need that. Keep forgetting to save. If you don't save here, it doesn't update here, which obviously it doesn't, but it's one of those things that can drive you mad if you don't know what you're doing. Okay, so let's connect it. Sorry, I've done that wrong. We don't want the inventory in here. On the canvas to have the inventory. Did I add that? Yeah, the canvas needs to have the inventory. And then we'll make reference to our. So got your canvas. Add the inventory in there. And then I just have 10 of them. 10 of them, and it's inactive. So now we want, in the update loop, we want to be able to recognize when the player has pressed, has requested the inventory. So we'll say that that's pressing I. So if input.get key down. Keycode.g, no, that's keycode.i. So if you pressed I, we need to know, is the inventory there or not? So if inventory active, so if it's already active, then let's just hide the inventory. So if it's, if you press I when it's active, we'll hide it, otherwise we'll show it. So we need to call hide inventory. Else, if it's not active, then we want to show the inventory. Okay, and then we also need to recognize if it is active, we need to then move the selector around. So if inventory active, get key down. Keycode.e. So if you're pressing left, if the inventory is open and you're pressing E, you want to go left. But we only want to be able to go left if you're not in the first column. So if, and that's what these are for. So if selector X position is greater than 1. So if you've pressed left and you're not in the first column on the left, then you can go 1 left. So selector X position minus 1. And then we take that, do the opposite for if you're pressing D. If you're pressing D and it's less than the fifth column, then go up. Then if you're pressing up and the Y position is greater than 1, then the selector Y position goes down. And if you're pressing S and the selector Y position is less than 2, so that's row 1, that's row 2, that's column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you're in the second column, you can only go up. If you're in the top column, you only go down, and so on. So selector Y position plus plus. So if the inventory is active and you press, then press one of these keys, then it's going to move the selector around in the inventory. Okay, so and then what we'll do is we'll track whether or not that means we've change the position. actually, you don't need that because it would start off false anyway. Okay, so once you've checked if the inventory is active, and then you've checked if anyone's pressed the key, we want to then say if the fact that you've pressed the key means that the position has changed, then this is where we would update the selector position. So at this point we need to know what the X and Y position is, so then we can determine which box needs to be which image box needs to be updated with the new where is it, the new art with the yellow image. Okay. So, so what we'll do is we'll have two switches to determine what the X and Y positions are, and then when we know the X and Y position, we can determine which image needs to be updated. So if selector XY, selector Y position equals 1, and do this. Let's do that. So if it's position 1, then it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Where are we? In our canvas. If it's in position 5, then the first 5 are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. And the next 5 are these 5. So if it's 1, 1, then we need to update inventory position. Uh, machine. No, there's a much better way to do that. If you think about it logically, if it's one, then the position needs to be one less. So in the inventory position needs to be one less than the X position. So selector X position minus one. If that's one, if the Y is one, then it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's just one less. And if Y is two, then it's 6, 7, so it's 5. It's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, so it's 4 more. So that's an easier way of doing it, isn't it? You can tell I haven't really thought this through before doing it. So if the selector position is 2, then the send inventory position needs to be whatever the position is plus 4. So if it's Y is 2 and it's the second one along, then it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the second one is along, then the correct number is 4 more than that. So if we've made a change, then we need to send an inventory position. Okay. So let's update the selector. Selector. And we need to update it with the new position, which is there's a position change, update selector with the send inventory position. Okay, and then in here we get that number, and then we need to change the sprite, so it'll be something very similar like that. So let's copy that. Inventory position dot sprite. The background image we want, actually. So, background inventory position. Background inventory position with the new inventory position dot sprite needs to be a selector. So let's give this, let's have one more inventory sprite here. An inventory sprite 0, we'll give it two more, just to make this a little bit easier for us. So inventory position 0 is going to be a black box, 1 is going to be a yellow box. So whatever the inventory position we have, change it to whatever is in inventory sprite 1, which is that yellow box. Don't know what I've spelt wrong somewhere. Position. I'm getting old, you see. Okay, so change the sprite for whatever we've done to the new one. And then we also need to change the sprite of the old one. So before you change it, right. Keep that as a public one, so it doesn't make it private. If it was private, it would lose everything that's in the variable, so memory would wipe it after every update run. If we keep it public, then we'll know what the old one was, and that makes it a lot easier. So we've changed it to public, and what we'll do is, if there's a position change, then update old selector go to the old position and change it back to a black box. Find out the new position and change it to a yellow box. That's what we're doing here. Modifier public is not valid for this item. I disagree. So, right, so that now should mean that we can. It says we're missing a 1, 2, 1, 2. Deleted one for some reason. Better. Okay. Okay. So now when we press I, it should call show inventory. It should then show this. Once, when that's available, this is how we want to decide what the keys do. So the next thing we need to do is go back to the player controller and get that to recognize that if the inventory is active, don't move the player. So in our player controller, you probably need to make a reference. To our inventory, so let's try it that way. I don't really know. We'll see what happens. So let's have a private inventory. Start, let's get equals find object of type inventory imaging. So hopefully that'll then find that. And then down here, before we do anything, if BII dot, what did we say, was it? Inventory active. So if the inventory is active, if the inventory isn't active, rather, do this. If it is active, don't worry about it. So, when we press I, it should bring up this. It should then stop the player moving or doing anything until you press I again. When you move left and right, it should, a yellow box should move around here. That's the plan. So what we're doing, what we also need to do is make sure if there's anything, if we've just got a blank box in there, so if it's a black box in the inventory position, so if we don't hold anything, also change that to be yellow. So no matter what is in the inventory position, change the background sprite. But if you, in this inventory position, what you've got is a white box, not something in the inventory, then we also need to change the front, you know, the inventory position box. So we're changing them. So if it's that one, change it to yellow, and then also change. Sorry, if it's that one, change it to yellow, and also change that one to yellow. So let's give that a go. Well, it's showing straight away and it's not supposed to, so let's do something about that. So in here, get rid of that. Press I, that comes up. Press I, goes away. So press I. Oh. Index out of range exception. Index was outside the bounds of the array. Ah, it's because we haven't actually. We haven't actually put any images in here. We haven't actually told them what these are. So if we go to our canvas, we need to tie it all up. We've only got two images, but we haven't said what these are. What these inventory positions are, and we haven't added any of the background inventory positions, which should also be 10. So these are the backgrounds, so add that. Background inventory positions 1. next one. 4 into 3, 5 into 4, 6 into 5, 7 into 6, 8 into 7, 9 in, yeah. Let's see, we've done it wrong already. We've missed 2 out. So 2 should have went in there. 3 into 3, 4 into 4. See, the clue was in the title. No. 4. This could be a very long day. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then the inventory slots do exactly the same thing. So these. 1. Right. Let's save that and try it again. Right. My player's walking. Oh, there we go. It's doing some crazy stuff. Oh. So, it's doing some really crazy stuff. But what we can see. Because we're going 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's not how we set it up. Let's just move these out of the way for a second. In fact, let's just delete these inventory slots because they're just confusing things. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's delete those 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That goes over there. 1, 2, 3. Right. So someone with half a brain would have figured this out already. 198.3. Let's just call that 22. Because that's easier to type. So they all need to be 22. Okay, and they all. We don't want any gaps. So that's 1. I call that 198. -198, and then call this -98. Then 2, 102, and 202. Right. So then get these four. Copy them. Move them straight down. That's close enough. Right. And then get all of them. And get a copy of them where they are. Right. We're getting there. Go back to our canvas and let's sort all this out again. So where are we? Canvas. Right. Inventory position. Background position. Right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And then let's change these names. Just, you don't have to, but it's just so we know that we're looking at the front or the back. Right, so they're all updated. Go back to the canvas and then add back to the canvas and then add them here. So the inventory slot. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Right. So there we go. Let's try again. Now, before we do that, the inventory needs to be switched off before we start. Okay. So we can walk around, and then if we press the I, it gives us an inventory. Right. So I can go up and down. But what we didn't do is set the X and Y position to begin with. And also, it's also not updating, changing the background colour back to black when we're finished looking at it. And because we're using a box that has an alpha background, it's just showing the complete, it's just showing you the back of the the background. So let's press I to come out of that. Go back into the inventory and then go back to Visual Studio. We still haven't set the image. So this is the bit that's not happening. It's not updating the old. Well, it is, but just the background and not the foreground. So we want that to zero. And now when you go off it, it'll go back to black instead of staying yellow. As I said, we need the X and Y positions set. So we need them set from the beginning. So let's do that here. I mean, you could do it programmatically, but we might as well do it here. It's easier. X and Y position. Event your active, no. Position change, no. One and one. What we need is a new background image. Select white, add that in here. Then add that box select white to there. And then that needs to be the next position. So the background needs to be 3, 2. Background needs to be 2. So let's try that one more time. I think that'll be the next time before we actually get to add something to the inventory. Take a lot longer than I was expecting, but there you go. I'll just get away from these baddies so I don't get killed. Right, press I for the inventory. And then we can select the box, select and moves around the two. So we need it to automatically start there. So next thing is when we first start here, we need to call update selector. So update selector, what's it called? Yeah, it is called update selector. What I've done there is I accidentally added all these procedures and functions and things under the larger void update instead of just as part of the class. So that's what I've updated there. So now that when it first starts, it should update selector 1. So it should show, should see that in yellow when it first starts. So we'll try that, and then we also try putting an image in just to show it works. So I right, when it first starts, the original position needs to be 0, not 1. That's why that wasn't working. If we look here, because in an array, the first item is 0. That's why the confusion was there. So now when we start, it should start with the yellow box, and then we can move the yellow box around. Get rid of this. I to get it. Have a look around. Move it. I to get rid of it. And he doesn't move. So the final thing is to change the sprite. So let's just see what happens if we let's add a new picture to our inventory sprites. It's a barrel, see. So element 3 is a barrel. So just to game the system, let's put an image in there. So not to game the system, what am I talking about? just to test it works. So change the image. Inventory position. So let's see in the middle one on the top, which is 3. And the inventory sprite for a barrel. What did we say that was? 3. So put this image in 3 in this slot here, the third one across. Well, as soon as it opens. So when the inventory comes up, it should show that we've got something in the inventory. Hopefully, what that'll do is leave the background as it is and just update the picture in the front. Then when we go to select it, it'll see that there isn't inventory, that in the front image doesn't have just a blank box, and so it won't change it to a yellow. We'll only see the yellow background. So let's give that a go. Over here. Well, it's not the position I thought it would be, but there you go. So we now have a barrel in there. Hopefully when we go over it, it gets a yellow box over it and doesn't replace it. Well, so it's 0, 1, 2, 3. So 2 is the middle one. So let's fix that first of all. Secondly, we need to know why when we go over it, it's changing both the front and the back image. It should be just changing the back one because it should recognize that actually the sprite is element 3. So another thing, we didn't tell it to stop updating the position, so it kept logging. So we've caught that. Not what we're looking for, but we've caught it. Let's try again. So I press I. It should get a new debug line when I move. So 1. Nothing there when you go in. And when you go. So when it's not when you hit it, it's when you, when it updates the old one. So update old selector, this will need the same logic, need this logic again. So and this one, so if it was 1, put it back to 0, otherwise leave it alone and just change the background. So, third time's a charm. Over here, press I. So there we go. So now we can select. It knows there's a barrel there. It's a pretty feeble looking barrel, but it knows it's there. So there you go. It took a while, I'll accept. But there we go. We now have, from last week, we have an inventory system. And then this week, we have a way to show show images dynamically in the inventory system. Next time, what we'll do is we'll look to populate the inventory system with inventory items based on what is actually in our inventory. So if we pick up a barrel, it'll show that there's a barrel when we look at the inventory. And then we'll need to start looking at how we move things around the inventory, or, you know, how we get rid of them. Do we drop it? Do we buy and sell? Maybe we show something in the inventory to tell us what it is. Maybe you click on it and it says it's a barrel and it's worth 2 gold or whatever. So there you go. There you go. I think that's, we're about 3 hours in, and that'll do for this week. Thank you very much. And I hope you're enjoying it.